enforcement has called in law enforcement after receiving a letter full of glitter from a group hoping to make a political statement.
That's right. Our John Chapman is finding out the so-called glitter bomb isn't too rare. He continues our complete coverage.
Imagine you open your mail and find a letter full of glitter. This stuff gets all over the place, and now you have a big mess.
Check the internet. For a few dollars, you can send anyone a glitter-filled greeting card. It's captured headlines and has been going on for years. People throwing glitter or sending letters or spring-loaded tubes full of glitter through the mail. These so-called glitter bombs are often aimed at politicians. Nebraska Congressman Jeff Fortenberry was a recent victim of a glitter bomb loaded with a message. The letter was not appreciated. Congressman Fortenberry responded, "Anyone is free to disagree with me, but to resort to these tactics in a heightened threat environment is reckless and a waste of precious law enforcement resources." Fortenberry called the police and the FBI, but Creighton Law Professor Mike Finner says since there was no threat in the letter, no laws were broken.
The federal laws regarding threatening danger, threatening injury, or threatening death to a congressman, they wouldn't apply. And if there was a statute that applied to just general threats, the First Amendment would prohibit prosecuting whoever sent this glitter bomb because it just wasn't a true threat.
Some people might think the glitter bomb is a harmless joke. It might be for you and I, but over the years, politicians have had to deal with more dangerous things coming through the mail.
Anthrax was being sent to members of Congress. That's when they started getting afraid of it. You know, before that, I think you opened an envelope and some glitter fell out. You just swept it up and thought, okay, you know, okay, this is kind of cute. This is somebody's idea of a joke or somebody's way to get our attention regarding a particular issue. But when anthrax started coming into the offices, then people started getting concerned, worried, scared.
We did talk to the FBI today, and they agreed with Professor Finner. FBI officials say no threat was made in the Fortenberry glitter bomb case, so no federal laws were broken. With photographer Image Danker, John Chapman, WOWT 6 News.